Hey everyone, this is Joe, and I'm going to be showing you how to change the laptop screen on your Dell Inspiron 7559. This process is virtually the same for most laptops. It involves all the same steps, but in case you happen to have a Dell Inspiron 7559, you'll be able to see exactly what to do. Again, it's a very simple process. All we're going to do here is we're going to take this bezel off. We're going to remove four screws. We're going to lay the monitor down gently. Unplug it. Move it to the side. Put the new one down. Plug it in. Put the screws back in. Bezel back on. And that's it. Again, it's a simple process, but a lot of people haven't ever tackled something like removing a screen, and it seems way more complicated than it is. So I'll go ahead and walk you through it and show you exactly what you want to do. Now, one thing you're going to need is a screwdriver. Just a small Phillips like this will be perfect. There's also small laptop screwdrivers. I have one somewhere, but I just like this little guy here. First, to get this bezel off, you just fill around for a loose spot. If you don't have one, I can go anywhere and start and make one. You don't have to be too gentle either. I've heard people say, be real gentle. You want to be somewhat gentle. You don't want to really pull. But as you'll see, you can just pull it right off. You don't have to be too gentle. The reason you want to be a little gentle is there's prongs here that snap together. You don't want to break those off. So be a little gentle, but don't be so afraid that you don't get in there and really get it off. And then these little things at the bottom, they just pop right out. Simple as that. Now we want to remove the screws. There's four of them. One, two, three, four. Top and bottom. There's some on the side here. You might think you need to remove those. Leave those alone. They don't need to come off. Just these four. Very tiny screws, so be careful. I always like to leave one on top just to make sure it doesn't fall forward or anything silly. Now when you get this last one off, you might want to kind of hold the screen together. Make sure it doesn't fall forward. I know you're not worried about your broken screen, but there's a cord connecting the laptop to the monitor, and you just don't want to have that, you don't want to damage that at all. So when you lay this down, just do so like this. Don't pull the screen away, because you could damage this cord. You could rip it out from over here. And then that's a lot more complicated to fix. So what we do here is there's just a little piece of tape right here connecting the connector to the screen. You just pull that tape up like so, and then just pull away. Don't pull up, just pull away like that. That's it. It's unplugged. Then we just move that to the side. We get our new screen, which I have right here. We lay it in the same position, and we do the same thing that we just did, just in reverse. We plug it in, from this way in. Make sure it's nice and secure, push it all the way in, and then just tape it back down. And then there's this cord here, there's these little prongs. That cord will usually come out from those prongs a little, so just make sure they're back in there in place. And then we set it back up. put it back on, I like to do the top ones first, just so I know it ain't gonna move around too much. Very tiny screws, so. And my hands aren't the steadiest, so bear with me here. See, we're almost done. It's as simple as this. Now that we got it screwed back in, we just take our bezel. You just place it right back down in there. It'll snap a little. Even if it doesn't snap, it's fine. I'll show you at the end how you can snap it back in place. And then you just go around and just snap everything back together. Up in the front, it's always tricky on most laptops I've done this to. You just gotta, you don't want to press too hard, but just kind of feel around and you'll see. You'll get it. There we go. There's one there. There we go. Perfect. On the back, mine snap together, but there's right here. If it's not snapped together, just press it together like that. Right here, same thing. Just press it together. And that's it. Now let's kick it on and you should be good. Let's see. Perfect. Okay, so now you can have confidence you can do it yourself too. Thanks.